The story you're about to hear is called A Visit to the North Pole, read by Madeline Walton-Hadlock. This story is loosely based on a Christmas tale from 1916 called A Visit to Santa Claus Land, written by Georgine Faulkner. This is a Library Call adaptation and recording. You probably know all about Santa's toy workshop up in the North Pole. But did you know that a very special garden grows nearby? Neither did Zara and her little brother Theo, but they were about to find out. One night, just before Christmas, Zara and Theo's mom tucked them into bed, kissed them goodnight, and closed the door to their room. Did they sleep? No, they did not. Theo wiggled. Zara tossed and turned. Finally, they both sat up. "Theo," Zara whispered, "are you asleep?" "No," he said, "I can't sleep. I keep thinking about Santa. I wish we could visit him in the North Pole." All of a sudden, they heard a quiet tap, tap, tap on the window. They looked out, and there on the windowsill sat a man with pointed ears and friendly eyes. He was thin and very short, about half the height of a child. He was wearing a green wool suit and gardening gloves.
"Did I hear you say you'd like to see Santa Claus? I'm on my way back to the North Pole. I'll take you with me if you'd like."
Zara and Theo scrambled from their beds in excitement.
"But who are you?" asked Zara.
"I'm an elf, of course. My name is Jack."
"Do you build toys in Santa's workshop?" asked Theo.
"No, I work in the garden. And when I have time, I give children tours."
"Would you like to visit the North Pole? I can have you back home in a couple of hours."
"Yes!" they cried.
"Now, the location of Santa's home is a secret, so you must promise to close your eyes on our journey."
Zara and Theo obediently squeezed their eyes shut so they couldn't see a thing. Jack took the children's hands, gave a wink, and off they went. It seemed as if they were flying through the window. They traveled swiftly for a while. Then the elf whirled them round and around till the children couldn't tell which way was up and which way was down. Only a few minutes later, they stopped.
"Here we are," said the elf. "You may open your eyes."
The children blinked as their eyes adjusted to the brilliant light of the stars in the clear night sky. They looked up and saw a huge red gate in front of them. The elf knocked and the gate swung open, revealing the most amazing garden the children had ever seen. There were rows and rows of Christmas trees, all glittering with ornaments and tinsel. And instead of flower or vegetable beds, there were beds of sweet treats. Zara ran over to a bed of candy canes.
"Let's see if any of them are ripe," said Jack.
"Ripe?" said Zara in surprise.
"Yes, of course," said the elf. "You'll know this one is ripe if its stripes have turned a deep red color."
The elf picked the candy cane and handed it to Zara. She inspected its stripes and saw that they were a bright shade of pink.
"Nope, it's not ripe yet. Try this one," said Jack, handing her another candy cane.
"Zara, come over here," Theo called. Zara ran towards Theo and saw rows and rows of gingerbread. Gingerbread people, gingerbread animals, gingerbread houses, and gingerbread toys, all growing right up out of the snow.
"Can we gather some of these?" Theo asked the elf.
"Certainly. Let's see if this one is ripe."
Jack picked a gingerbread giraffe and broke it in two.
"Did you hear that snap? That's how you know it's ripe."
The children laughed and each picked a gingerbread cookie for themselves. The next garden bed they visited was filled with pies. There were apple pies, pumpkin pies, mince pies, coconut pies, chocolate pies.
"You'll know these are ripe when they start to steam," said Jack.
He handed them forks, and the children lingered in that part of the garden for a long time.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.